gears are quite an interesting thing to manufacture. It's been months of hard work to get to the position where we've got these gears to finally get to assemble a gearbox.
And here it is, the very first GT50 speed reduction gearbox assembled and ready for test. The speed reduction gearbox, as simple as it looks, actually brings together years of work in developing the design technology and also all of the process and production technology to be able to produce sophisticated drivetrain components for turbine engines. The speed reduction gearbox itself takes in the power turbine outlet at 36,350 RPM and then reduces that through a multi-stage gearbox arrangement inside down to about 6,000 RPM as the input to the main rotor gearbox and the input to the tail rotor drive gearbox down the back of the helicopter.
The gears that we've got here that are in our gearbox are, I would say, fairly tightly controlled. We're looking at round about class 5 gears on an ISO standard, which would put us in the three parameters that we want to check, which are profile slope deviation, which is effectively the trend of the tooth and how it is behaving in the plane. We've got the total profile deviation, which gives us an indication of how that is moving as a full shape. And then we've got effectively the tooth form. So across those three parameters, we're looking for tolerances in the region of plus or minus 5 micron for the first one, 8 micron for the second, and 6 for the form, which puts us really at the high end of accuracy. So the machine behind me is what we classify as a high accuracy, ultra high accuracy CMM. So that's perfect for this kind of job. And what we do with that machine is we trace the gear flanks as you would do the traditional gear checker. And we then start to produce the profile plots. And with that, we can feed back to the machinist really, very clearly about how the tools have interacted with that part and what adjustments they need to make.
In order to get the speed reduction gearbox designed and then built, we've had to develop all of the processes necessary to cast and then subsequently machine lightweight alloy casings that are capable of holding the crucial components of the gearbox, the gears, in exactly the right place. So as the gear teeth roll together, they create the right contact pressure from tooth to efficiently and reliably transmit that load for 5,000 hours. So developing the casings is really a trade-off between making them light enough to fly, but stiff enough to work properly. And when you look at the detail of making casings, if you look at this one, once we've cast the basic shape, we then have to go in and machine all of the critical dimensions for flanges and sealing. You can see the seal channels here. For locating the bearings to hold the gears tightly into mesh. And when we start removing material from these faces in a cast component, because the components themselves are so thin-walled, they tend to warp and to move. So in order to reliably make these parts in a way that when we come and measure them and when we fit them up to their adjacent parts, everything fits properly, everything seals, and the adjacent bearing races are all in exactly the right position, we've had to develop a whole host of specialist machining strategies, tools, jigs, fixtures, stress relieving and heat treatment processes. There's a whole tomb of work that goes into just being able to make lightweight but stiff casings really, really well. Then of course there's all of the processes necessary to manufacture gears. Gears in aerospace applications again are extremely demanding components to design and to manufacture. We have to make gears that are extremely lightweight, but again they need to be stiff enough to maintain that accurate gear mesh. They need to be strong enough and have a high enough fatigue life to run for 5,000 hours plus without incurring a failure. And so all of the process controls that go into making these components have to be extremely tightly controlled. You've watched us manufacture from the highest quality aerospace gear steels, the blanks holding extremely tight tolerances on the bores and on all of the key datum surfaces. You've then watched us develop all of the heat treatment processes that allow us to maintain the core of the gear soft and tough so that it stands up to its duty without allowing fatigue cracks to grow readily through the material. And then you've watched us develop the processes to rough out and then harden the gear teeth so the gear teeth themselves can stand up to the severe wear environment that they operate in when they're carrying the high torque loads that you see in helicopter transmissions. Once we've done that, you've watched us develop chop peening processes to peen down in between the gear teeth to make sure where adjacent teeth open and close as you load the gear as one tooth passes onto the next, that we can maintain extremely high fatigue integrity down in those highly stressed regions of the tooth. On top of that, you've got all of the plating processes so that we can selectively carburize. And then, of course, the really sophisticated measurement processes that we need to be able to manufacture these gears to the tightest of tolerances. And that's important for long life of the gears, but it's also important to make sure these gears run smoothly and quietly, which is a key parameter for both GT50 and HX50 for the current and future applications. So bringing this gearbox together with gears made out of the right materials, using the right processes to the right standards, and clawing our way up the learning curve for each of those things marks a real milestone in our capability to design, manufacture, and now test aviation hardware for turbine engines and the broader helicopter transmission. So that's the gears. One of the areas that we get a lot of commentary about is the necessity that we found to design and manufacture bearings in-house. This isn't a decision that we took lightly. This was purely driven by the commercial realities of the cost of bearings and the sheer number of them that we need in HX50 and GT50.
We've been putting a lot of effort into perfecting the finish on these bearings. So in the inner and outer races, the surface finish is really critical to make sure that you don't build up a harmonic resonance when the bearings are running at high speed. Some of the critical checks we have to perform on those are surface finish checks. So we've got our roundness tester over to the side here. On that, we can get down to really, really tiny numbers of microns. And we're looking for roundnesses in the order of 2 to 5 micron generally to make sure that when these are running at the several tens of thousands of RPM, that they're not going to create the harmonics that are going to cause a failure.
So these two gearboxes, this is the first one, this is the second one that we've got stripped at the moment to show you, use hill bearings. So the first bearings that we've focused on are the very high speed ones that operate right at the top of the engine with an input speed of 36,350 RPM. So 500 horsepower at 36,000 RPM goes into that gear through this top bearing. And that's entirely manufactured from us, by us. So that's a hill design. We've manufactured both the races, the cage, and everything else that goes into it. We're reliably now hitting the tolerances. We're reliably hitting the surface finishes. We're meeting all of the harmonic criteria that you need to assure long life. And now it's time to get it into the gearbox and get it tested. But that too brings together the culmination of literally years of work, significant investment in the infrastructure that you need to be able to do this, and now it's time to put it on the bench and test it. So we're really, really excited to see all of this stuff, which has been very hard won over the last few years, coming together and delivering on the test bench. So when you come over here and see the full assembly of the gearbox, what you can see here is, in addition to the core transmission elements, so you've got our casings, you've got the input stage here, splines, gear teeth, bearings, the two-stage gearbox reduction within the casing, the output stage here into the drive shafts that form the rest of the module 4 of the engine that we'll show you later. You can see the engine mounts here, and then all of this white wire you can see is the wires for the instrumentation that we've put in for the development gearboxes. So we've got thermocouples, temperature sensors, chip detectors, pressure sensors, a whole plethora of instrumentation. So we can measure every vital function of the gearbox while we've got it on test over in the high-speed test lab. So literally years and years of work in the making to develop each of the processes, to develop all of the designs, to be able to make the very highest quality aerospace components for a price that general aviation can afford. The day was always going to come when it was time to put the hardware on the bench, and here's the first major part of it. And now it's time to put it on the test rig and see how well it works.